Well, hello and welcome to For Pet's Sake. We're here at Incredible Pets with Scooter's Pals, and it looks like a few of the Dobbins dogs and Pound Puppy Rescue is also here, and a lot of volunteers, people interested in helping these homeless animals, and you're going to meet a lot of them today, and obviously the animals that need homes. If you're interested, stay tuned. If you're not, watch the show. We have a lot to share with you, and stay tuned. Thank you. Well, hello again, and I'm here with a wonderful volunteer. Her name is Casey. Hi, Casey.
Hello.
Boy, she's here every Adopt-a-thon, and I really, really want to thank you for that. And she has a dog named Coco here that needs a home. Could you tell us about Coco?
She's 7 to 8 years old. We think she's a chow something something. Yeah, maybe lab. She's really, really fast, so we don't know what, but she's a good runner. She had heartworm. She's treated for it. She's fine now. She's really energetic, despite the fact that she's 7 to 8 years old. She's really, really good dog.
Well, she looks pretty healthy, and I notice she smiles when you pet her. And I think I've pointed this out to you guys before. She just loves to be petted, and she needs her forever home. She's shiny black, she's got a curly black tail, and she loves people. If you have cats or another dog, we could test her out with that to see if it would work out. She'd probably work best in a only dog home, but then again, you never know, because we get dogs in homes that we think they're not gonna get along with the dog, and they click. So you might want to test her out in your home. If you do decide to adopt Coco or any of the animals that are shown here today, we do take them back if they don't work out. There's a time period there that it takes time to adjust. So again, spay, neutered, microchipped, vaccinated, and ready to go into your home. And this is Coco, and she's a smiler. If you like a smiler, Coco's for you. Well, hello, and I'm here again with a wonderful female dog that needs a home, a homeless dog, and in foster care with Becky. Hi, Becky.
Hi. Yeah, this is Abby.
And Abby seems to be in this, getting excited about the holidays here.
Yes, she is really into the season. She's a good girl, nice and calm girl. She's a, we're thinking a corgi beagle cross, and she just took off her ornament. But yeah, she's not eating it, which is really good. So she is a very nice dog, good walker. If anybody likes to walk, she loves to walk. And she is an alpha female. Be good if she was in a home with larger dogs or by herself. And she's housebroken. She can sit and lay down. She uses a dog door. So there's a lot of good traits that she has, and we really, really enjoy her in our home.
Well, I know Abby's been in the program for a while, so we need, when we get these dogs' homes, we make room for other dogs that we can save. Otherwise, we don't have any room. And a goal for the season is to get all the animals in Scooter's Pals adopted before Christmas. Wouldn't that be amazing? Or we can get some more homes and we can get some more out of the shelters. But anyway, you can call. And Becky, what is your phone number?
It's 477-9073, and Abby did have a litter of puppies. That's why she's been out of the system for a while, raising her puppies, and her puppies have all been adopted out, and now it's her turn to find a home.
Well, she's a beautiful dog. She's all healthy and beautiful red. Abby, turn around there so we can see your face. And if you're interested in Abby, please call that number,
530-477-9073.
There is something else I wanted to inform you about. Well, Becky could. It's regarding the book drive. Is that still going on?
Yes, we do take used novels. They can be hardback or paperback. And we collect them, and then I take them down to a place in Penryn who buys them from us. And we use that cash to pay for spay and neutering, heartworm testing, all the vaccinations on our dogs. So we've raised several thousand dollars with used books. So if anybody's got some books, they can give me a call, 477-9073, and I can arrange to get them picked up or have you drop them off with me.
Well, really, thank you for that, too, because it raised some funding to help feed and vaccinate and get these animals ready for their new forever homes. And later on the show, I'm going to talk to you about adoption fee and why they apply. And it's very important that there is an adoption fee. We don't sell dogs. We adopt them out and place them in their forever homes. So give us a call at 530-265-9335 or 530-277-0476. And you know what? You can save a life before Christmas. Thank you. Well, hello. I'm here with Susan Wallace, the founder of Scooter's Pals. Hi, Susan.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good. I noticed there's just a big, beautiful brute here. And could you tell us his name and his story? Oh, he's so cute.
His name is Chopper, and he's very friendly, and he's deaf, but not totally deaf. And he doesn't really have the nature of most deaf dogs that have kind of checked out. He watches you so much that when you put your hand on your leg, he comes. He's very much not a deaf dog, even though he's hearing impaired. He's at the Grass Valley Shelter. Right now he's at Diane Benton's out on Dog Bar. She's an in-home kind of border gal. And she's doing Chopper as a favor just because she's a decent person. And Cheryl Wicks and I have kind of decided we were going to help this dog. We have heartworm treated him, and he's been neutered, and he's got all his shots. So he's really ready to go. There'll be no expense for this dog, and he's adoptable from the city Grass Valley Shelter on Freeman Lane over there. Their hours, I think, have changed. It's like 2 to 4, so that's a little narrow to have people come out. If you want to see this dog, call me or Cheryl, and we'll make this happen for this dog because we just adore him. He's so great. And we'll treat him like any one of our own.
Well, the number to call is 530-265-9335, 301-9335, same area code, and 530-272-8833, and that is Cheryl. So you can contact any of these people or numbers and get a hold of Chopper. He is just to die for. He is so cute. Why don't you give this dog a home for Christmas? Wouldn't it be nice? Or the holidays, whatever you celebrate all through the year. Maybe, though, before December 25th, Chopper can be in your home. Thank you, Susan, for what you do. We're going to talk to Susan again during the show regarding Scooter's upcoming events and the wonderful things that Scooter's does for these animals. And stay tuned. Well, hello again, and we have another dog that needs a home, and we have Carl here, who is fostering. He's the co-founder of Scooter's Pals, and he is fostering Prudence amongst maybe two or three other dogs. So tell us about Prudence.
Prudence is a very nice purebred chow. She has good house manners. She gets along with most dogs. She does tend to want to be the dominant female sometimes, but she'd be a great pet with another male, and she's also good with children, house trained, and around 2 or 3 years old.
Well, she sure is gorgeous, and around the holidays, I keep reminding you, let's get these dogs homes and everybody have a wonderful holiday and empty out our rescue of the dogs that need homes, and then we can bring in more and save more. And Prudence is a beautiful dog, and she is just, well, designer dog, wouldn't you say? Beautiful, 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 grayish color, and she shimmers and when it's really sunny outside, her fur just shimmers, and she's so soft. And for therapy, you could brush her. What a wonderful, wonderful thing to do is to brush her. She does need to keep brushed and cleaned and groomed. So, again, Prudence is up for adoption. Call 530-277-0476. And around the holidays, we all want to do what we can for the animals and whatever we want to do to help during the holidays. So we're here to help the animals, and I hope you are. Save a life. 530-277-0476 if you're interested in this beautiful dog here, Prudence. Okay, I'm here with Lori again, and she seems to know about all the little dogs. It's really, really amazing to me. Tell us about this one.
This is Shannon. She's a little over a year old. She came from the Grass Valley City Shelter, and she was an owner turn-in. And she's a rat terrier, purebred. And she's a sweet little girl. She's spayed. She's up to date on all her shots. She gets along great with other dogs. She's in a wonderful foster home right now, but she is very ready for her new forever home.
So in order for people to find out about little Shannon, what number do they call? You prefer email? Give them your email.
My email address is ajack50@sbcglobal.net, and my number is 263-1876. You can call me and find out about Shannon, or you can go to Scooter's Pals website, and she'll be listed on there probably by Monday.
ScootersPals.org. Scooters, S-C-O-O-T-E-R-S, Pals, P-A-L-S, .org. Please inquire about Shannon. She's waiting for her forever home. She got a new little jacket today. Isn't it cute?
It's getting a little bit chilly today.
We had somebody donated some jackets. Her name is Barbara Kendrick, and I want to thank Barbara out there for doing that. All these little guys are getting they're warm today because you donated these wonderful jackets. So thank you, and there's more to share with you. Well, I have a story here that we all could learn from, and puppies, they're awfully cute, but we need to spay and neuter. I'm going to introduce you to, what is your name again?
Kitty Thomas.
Kitty Thomas. I know there was a situation in Dobbins, and it's been in the local newspaper, and there were puppies and dogs weren't spay or neutered. They were living in conditions that really were not up to par. So we have an adult dog here and some puppies, and I'm sure they're all over the place being fostered and socialized. So tell us about this situation.
Well, the gentleman had a large heart, and it kind of got out of control. He was helping these dogs. There was only one that was spayed, and so it started to snowball on him. He just couldn't handle taking care of them, and so most of them have been all taken off the property and spayed and neutered. This one right here is Jackie. He's a year old. He and another one, Bear Bear, are living with me. These little puppies are about 4 months. So the dogs range between about 2 years and 4 months old, and they're all being fostered and socialized, and they're doing great. They all have big hearts, and they're sweet dogs.
Well, they have a big heart, and you do too, and I want to thank you personally for doing this along with everybody else. And I know Kathleen from Pound Puppy Rescue and Cheryl from Sammy's Friends have been working together, and Scooter's Pals, the combined efforts, and along with all the foster homes. And I want to thank you. And this dog's name again? Is her name?
This one is Jackie. He's a little boy. And they can go to www.poundpuppyrescue.org and get all the information and see the puppies that need to be adopted.
Do you happen to know a phone number off the top of your head?
I don't know the phone number that she would like to use right now, but I have only the website, and you can contact through there.
So it's poundpuppyrescue.org, and there's adoption applications online that you can fill out online and inquire about these Dobbins dogs. And she also has other dogs that are up for adoption. I know Kathleen has done a tremendous amount of work helping these animals. I know she takes in all the puppies that come into the shelter so they don't get parvo. And that way we keep the parvo out and the puppies are all, isolated. And it has really, really helped with the problem with that. And Kathleen, poundpuppyrescue.org. And you can always call me at 530-272-8323 if you have any questions about any of these organizations, because I can answer your question. And if I can, I can refer you to the right place. So again, thank you. 51 dogs, is that right?
Dogs, and I think about 34 of them have been now taken off and spayed and neutered and are just as happy as can be.
The key is spay and neuter. If we don't spay and neuter, we have these homeless animals, as cute as they are. They're not in their forever home, and this dog's so scared. They were not socialized, but now they're getting socialized, and they're getting a lot more confident. So thank you for watching, and there's
thank
more
you.
For me to tell you.
Mm-hmm.
You like that? Okay, I'm here again. I didn't realize there's another one of these Dobbins dogs here. And which one's this?
This is Toby. He is 2 years old, and he is ready for a home. He is the sweetest little boy in the world. He's learned his name. He's learned leash work. And he is one of the first ones I started to get to know. And look at him. He's ready for somebody to have a home.
Well, he's a sweetheart. I know there were two people interested in him today, but it doesn't always work out. We don't depend on that. So this dog is ready for its forever home. It's not she boy, girl.
This is a little boy, Toby, 2 years old. Some sort of a shepherd cross mix. He's probably not going to get much bigger than this. He might beef up a little bit in about a year, but he is a sweetheart. Gets along, knows his name. He's ready.
Houndpuppyrescue.org, and go to the website to inquire about these dogs. There are puppies and adult dogs, middle-aged dogs that need homes. So again, houndpuppyrescue.org. Well, hello. We're going to close the show now, and I kind of wanted to inform you about something, is that when you adopt an animal or get a pet, don't buy one or get one for someone for Christmas. This is not an object. This is a living thing. If you want to, go to the shelter or go to your local rescue organization, scooterspals.org, and you can give them a gift certificate, and they can pick out a dog that suits them. What do you think about that, Susan?
I think that's fine. I think that we have people calling all the time that want to get dogs for their girlfriend or boyfriend, and we really discourage that, because the person who's going to have the duty to care for the dog needs to bond into the dog, and they need to choose their partner or their animal partner. So while it's well-intentioned, I think it's a mistake more often than not. Not always, but why risk it?
Right, and I want to ask you, what's happening with Scooters? Any upcoming events or anything you can inform the public about what's happening?
We have a new program that we are always getting people calling us, not always, wish it was always, but we often get people calling us that want to help, but they can't foster and they can't adopt right now. And so Lori developed with Janet this Guardian Angel program where people are signing up to pledge to contribute a small amount of money monthly, so we know that we have the resources to care for our special needs dogs. We don't really go out of our way to find special needs dogs, but they find us. So I'm just very grateful for them for thinking of this. So we had I think we've had three people so far that have pledged $40 a month, and that's really very generous, and we certainly don't expect that much, but we now have Precious, who's a diabetic dog, who her insulin does cost us $50 a month, and those strips cost, and we're going to find her a home, but it's going to be slow. And then there's Benson, who Carl is taking care of and fostering, that's got kidney problems and has to have a special diet for his kidney malfunction. And then there is Russell, who has that hip problem, and then there are others that are I'm blocking out right now because I'm on the air, but Lori and Janet know them all. And if you email Lori at ajack50@sbcglobal.net, Lori is hearing impaired and she prefers email, so or call me and I'll put you in touch with her. And I'm Susan, and I'm at SusanW1068@AOL.com, and you know my number, 301-9335.
Well, it's a busy time for you. I know just last night I was over at the Cornish Christmas, and there was a dog that was found that had the Scooters Pals microchip, and so of course you have a volunteer that went for the rescue and got the dog. It's never ending. Please be responsible with your pets.
They were reunited this morning, so they had a worrisome night last night, but they got their dog back today.
And we understand that does happen, but again, put a tag on your pet, on the collar, with the name and the number.
Well, they had our collar, which is better than nothing.
And luckily, Scooters tagged the dog. But anyway, I would love for you to give one of these animals that we introduced you to a forever home before Christmas, December 25th. If not, it can be after that. And Thank you, and for love.
For life.
For
so
pet's
this
sake.
Is Christmas. And what have you done? Another year over. And a new one just begun. And so this is Christmas. I hope you had fun. The near and the dear ones, the old and the young. A very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Let's hope it's a good one. So happy.